In this video, you are going to learn about various types of walls. After watching this video, you will be able to differentiate among different types of walls without any confusion. Although there are so many types of walls, but I have chosen 13 most common types of walls. Hi guys, this is Pawan Kumar and you are watching RKB Studies. So without any further ado, let's start the video. So the first one we have, load-bearing walls. So as the name suggests, load-bearing walls, the walls which support all the weight above them and their own weight. Okay, so if a building is a load-bearing structure, then all the walls will be load-bearing walls. So a load-bearing structure don't have columns. So as you can see over in the right side image, this is a load-bearing structure. Okay, because all the weight is supported by the walls only. On the other side, in a frame structure, the columns, beams and slabs are responsible for supporting the total weight. So in frame structure, we don't find the load-bearing walls. And we can see the examples of load-bearing walls mostly in the older houses. Second, we can see in kachcha houses. Kachcha houses, villages, or in the places where the natural hazards like earthquake and cyclones are very less likely to come. Okay, so areas with low chances of earthquake and cyclone. Okay, second one we have non-load bearing walls. These walls do not support the load above them, okay, such as beams and slabs. These walls are mainly seen in the framed structures. So framed structures are the structure which have beams, columns and slab, and these three members are responsible for bearing the load of the building, like total weight of above building. And the purpose of using these walls is to separate rooms from outside. So third one is the partition wall. Partition walls are a type of non-load bearing walls, and these are mainly used to separate a part of a space, and their other function includes privacy for a space, acoustic setting, fire separation and etc. So take an example like there is a big hall and you want to make different sections in that hall for different purposes. So we will use partition walls, and these are made of light materials such as timber, plywood, wood wool, etc. Like here also in this is the office area. These are the partition walls. Fourth one we have shear wall. Shear walls are made in the high-rise framed structures such as apartments, and these walls resist the wind forces and seismic forces. Okay, so like if the wind direction is from this side, then these walls will stabilize, and if the wind direction is from this side in this face, then these walls will stabilize. If these walls are not made, there are chances of building getting affected because of these forces, and building might get serious damage. So as you can see, these walls are not made separately. These are made along with the beams, columns, okay, and slab. Yeah, fifth one is core wall. So core wall is a single wall starting from the lowest floor and goes till top or to the level we require. The core in a building have different functions such as to make a staircase, elevators, electrical cables, water pipes and risers all goes from there. So in simple words, if we say the core is used to transport something from one level to another level. Before moving to the next type, let me tell you about my second channel, that is Pawan Kumar Narrations. Over there I make inspirational videos with the help of poems, stories and quotes. So please do support me. So next we have retaining wall. So simply, the wall that supports soil laterally are known as retaining walls. So as you can see this side, this is the wall, okay, it is a cross section of wall, and this is the soil. So it is supporting the soil and it is resisting this pressure because of this soil. So as you can see in this image, this is the wall. So it is supporting the soil field over here, okay, this soil. So these are mostly used in the slopy land like mountainous regions, river banks, etc. Seventh, we have buttress wall. So you can see over here, all these walls, okay, all these supports are buttress walls. These walls serve as an exterior support for a wall in a building. Okay, so these are mostly made of masonry, and if you require more strength, we can make of RCC also. RCC means reinforced cement concrete. Like thrust is from this side on this wall, so these will support, these will stabilize it. Eighth one is cavity walls. So cavity wall is a two layered wall, and these walls are separated by some hollow space that we call cavity. Okay, so as you know that the air is a poor conductor of heat, so these walls are made if you require heat insulation in a building. And as you can see, these elements are used to keep these walls together. So ninth one, we have brick masonry wall. So brick masonry walls are simply the walls made using the bricks and mortar. Mortar means the paste used to hold two bricks together. This can be cement plus sand, lime plus sand, or soil only. The most important thing we have to note over here is all the bricks are of same sizes. Okay, the strength of these walls lies in the type of bond we use. Bond means the pattern of the bricks. So as you can see over here in this image, there is English bond, Flemish bond, and stretcher bond. So as you can see, the pattern of the bricks is changing, that only. So 10th, we have rubble masonry wall. In rubble masonry, the stones are used of different sizes, and these are undressed rough stones, and mostly these are used to make the outer boundary of the site, that too in the older houses. Okay, so next we have precast walls. Precast walls means the walls that are already made in a factory and then brought to site where we require, and then these are installed and fixed over there accordingly. So similar to the precast walls, precast stairs, precast pillars, precast beams are also available in market. So in this picture, these all are precast walls. So 12th, we have parapet wall. Parapet walls are made at the edges of the roof, and mostly these are an extension of the walls present below the roof. Okay, so safety and security are the only two purpose of making parapet walls. 13th and the last type, we have curtain walls. So these types of wall look some sort of curtain, that's why these are named as curtain walls. So curtain walls are constructed on the outer faces of the building. The purpose of curtain walls is to protect the interior spaces of the building from exterior natural phenomena such as rain, sunlight, etc. And it also increases the aesthetic beauty of the building. So now let's revise them. First one is load bearing wall. Second one is non-load bearing wall. Third one is partition wall. Fourth one is shear wall. Fifth one, core wall. Sixth one, retaining wall. Seventh one, buttress wall. Eighth one, cavity wall. Ninth one, brick masonry wall. 10th one, rubble masonry wall. 11th one, precast walls. 12th one, parapet wall. 13th one, curtain wall. That's it. If you have learned something new, now it's your turn to support this channel by liking the video, sharing with your friends, and subscribing this channel. And comment below on what topic do you want next video. And if you have any queries related to architecture and architecture entrance examination, you can approach me on Instagram, Facebook, and Telegram at RKB Studies. Thank you for watching.